Okay, good morning boys. Last class we have discussed about different classification of carbohydrates, and then we have discussed about the chemical properties of glucose. You know that from the chemical properties of glucose we can know some of the important facts regarding the structure of glucose. As we have already discussed that glucose has an aldehyde group at the first position, and then it has 5 hydroxyl groups, and we also come to know that it has 1 primary alcoholic group at the end. On the basis of these facts and studying the other configurational analysis, Fischer suggested an open chain structure of glucose. Remember, Fischer suggested an open chain structure of glucose after studying its stereochemical properties. On the basis of that and important properties of chemical properties of glucose, Fischer suggested the open chain structure of glucose, which is like this. Okay, these are the different asymmetric carbon atom. There are 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 asymmetric carbon atom, and the configuration of all these carbon atoms are written here. You see the first asymmetric carbon, that is first asymmetric carbon, the OH is at the right hand side. Second asymmetric carbon, OH is at the left hand side. Third asymmetric carbon, OH is right hand side, and fourth asymmetric carbon, OH is right hand side. So from the bottom, if you see, from the bottom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, from the bottom if you see the arrangement of the OH groups of the asymmetric carbon atoms are having this order: right, right, left, right. So see it here to understand it: right, right, left, right. These are the arrangement of hydroxyl groups of the asymmetric carbon atoms from the bottom. We usually take it from the bottom so as to keep it in our memory, that what are the arrangement of hydroxyl groups, OH groups from the bottom of the asymmetric carbon atoms. They are right, right, left, right. Keep it in mind. Now this is the structure, open chain structure suggested by Fischer. Secondly, after suggesting this structure, there are some anomalies appeared before us. What are the anomalies appeared before us? The first anomaly is, in spite of having a free aldehyde group as it is found in the structure, glucose does not give 2,4 DNP test, number one. Number two, it does not give CYPS test. And number three, it does not form sodium bisulfite addition product. These are the three important characteristics of aldehyde group. Keep it in mind. What are the important characteristics of aldehyde group? That aldehyde group, if a compound, organic compound, has an aldehyde group, it must give 2,4 DNP test. It must give CYPS test. And thirdly, it must form sodium hydrogen bisulfite product. But in case of glucose, we don't find so. So this is a contradiction. You can say contradiction against this Fischer open chain structure. Secondly, the pentaacetate of glucose. Pentaacetate, last class we have discussed about pentaacetate. Pentaacetate of glucose, these are the hydroxyl groups. So hydroxyl groups get acetylated by acetic anhydride. So these are the hydroxyl groups, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hydroxyl groups get acetylated with acetic anhydride, giving pentaacetate of glucose. It is already told in the last class. Now this pentaacetate of glucose, the glucose does not give the test of chemical test of aldehyde group. Does not give the chemical test of aldehyde group. See it here. Another contradiction, because the pentaacetate of glucose is having a free aldehyde group, but it does not give the test of chemical test of aldehyde group. So because of these anomalies, some more researches are done in order to find the actual structure of glucose, and it has been found that glucose in fact exists in two isomeric form, stereoisomeric forms, which are known as anomers in the aqueous solution. Glucose exists in two different isomeric forms, which are stereoisomers, I repeat, and these isomers are formed due to cyclization. Cyclization means formation of a cyclic means closed ring. Due to cyclization, glucose exists in two anomeric forms. They are known as alpha D plus glucose and beta D plus glucose. Alpha and beta, I want to discuss about their structure. Before that, I must say that the name is alpha D plus glucose because this glucose is dextrorotatory. This glucose is a dextrorotatory, so it is given plus sign. And why is D sign? Capital D sign is given because of its symmetry with D glyceraldehyde. The structure is COH and CH2OH. This is glyceraldehyde. There is only one asymmetric carbon atom in glyceraldehyde, and this asymmetric carbon atom, the OH group, attached to the asymmetric carbon atom at the right, and this configurational symmetry is given D sign. D sign is given for this configurational symmetry. D sign does not mean dextrorotatory. Remember, this does not mean dextrorotatory. This means that glyceraldehyde has only one asymmetric carbon atom, and the configuration of the D glyceraldehyde is same as that of the last asymmetric carbon atom of glucose. The lowest asymmetric carbon atom of glucose has the same configuration. See it here. Compare with it, same configuration, and so it is given D sign. So this one, Fischer open chain structure of glucose, is denoted as D plus glucose. So D is because of this symmetry, and plus is glucose is dextrorotatory in nature, so it is plus, and so it is written D plus glucose. Now, as I told you, that glucose does not exist in open chain structure in the aqueous medium because it undergoes cyclization. A cyclic ring is formed. The cyclic ring is formed between the first carbon atom and fifth carbon atom through this OH group. A first carbon atom and fifth carbon atom, the cyclic ring is formed. Okay, cyclic ring. These and these chemically interacts with each other to form a cyclic ring, and glucose mainly exists in cyclic form. So what are the cyclic forms? You see here, I am writing the diagrams. The first one is cyclic form is C, then 1, 2, 3, 4, in this way you will write CH2OH. This is OH, as you know, OH, this is H, this is OH, H, right, left, right. Now see it here. This and this, C, this is aldehyde group. Now a cyclic ring is formed by reacting with this OH. See it here. This one is the electron pair, interacts with this one. This bond breaks, pi bond breaks, and this joins to this, and this O minus joins with H plus. This is H plus because after joining it will be OH plus. See, H plus shifts to this O. Therefore, this carbon, the first carbon, will become asymmetric again. And what is its form? Look at the form. This is C, first carbon, OH. This O becomes OH, and there is a ring with oxygen atom, between the first carbon and the fifth carbon. So this is OH, this is H. Now write down second, third, fourth, fifth. The fifth one is connected with oxygen. This is oxygen. This oxygen is written here. This oxygen is written here. This is a cyclic ring between the first carbon and the fifth carbon through oxygen atom. Okay, now this carbon becomes asymmetric again. This carbon becomes asymmetric. It was not asymmetric initially, but after cyclization it forms asymmetric, it becomes asymmetric again. And the last one is CH2OH. What is the order? Right, right, left, right. So this right has been taken part in cyclization. This is right, 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 left, right. Now complete the structure. Complete the structure. This structure is the cyclic structure of glucose. In the cyclic structure of glucose, you see the first carbon atom is also asymmetric carbon atom. It was not asymmetric in the open chain structure, but after cyclization, it becomes asymmetric. After cyclization. Okay. So this form, the first carbon atom, asymmetric carbon atom, its OH is at the right hand side. So it can be at the right hand side, it can be at the left hand side. So where OH is at the right hand side, it is known as alpha form, or it is called alpha anomer. So what are anomers? Anomers are the stereoisomers. Anomers of glucose are the stereoisomers which differ at the configuration of C1. Which differ in the configuration of OH group at C1. So anomers are the stereoisomers of glucose which differ in the configuration of OH group at C1. Clear? Now the another anomer is beta form. Beta form, the OH group will be here and hydrogen will be here. Just reverse it. OH at the right hand side, that form is alpha form, alpha anomer, and OH at the left hand side, that form will be beta anomer. Therefore, you can write the beta anomeric structure of glucose in this way. This one is beta, C, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and this one is CH2OH. You write in this way, it is not asymmetric. Now, this one is through oxygen, this bond. Now, it is OH, right, right, left, right. From the bottom, this is the order. Here it is H, here it is OH, OH, here it is H, here it is H. So this one is the beta form of glucose, beta anomer. So try to understand. The open chain structure of glucose, that is not suited for us because it had some anomalies. It does not form bisulfite addition product. It does not give 2,4 DNP test. It does not give Skips test. So this open chain structure is ruled out. Okay, this structure derived on the basis of some chemical properties which already discussed before you, and studying the configurational analysis by Fischer, he presented this structure before us. But we are not accepting this structure because this structure is not capable of explaining certain facts which I told you. You must remember the facts. What is further analysis shows that glucose exists in two crystalline form, alpha anomer and beta anomer. These forms mainly contributes the glucose, alpha form and beta form. These two forms exist in equilibrium with open chain structure. This form, these three forms exist in equilibrium. Okay, the open chain structure exists in equilibrium with the alpha form and beta form. Beta form, in which the contribution of alpha form or beta form is 99.9%. Only 0.5% is the open chain structure in the aqueous medium. And that's why when we talk about their chemical test, these chemical tests are not given by glucose. Chemical test of aldehyde group is not given by glucose. Okay, because in aqueous condition, mainly this form and this form exist together in equilibrium with a little amount of 0.5% of open chain structure. Now come to this. This is the alpha enomer and this is the beta enomer. What is the difference between alpha and beta? There is no difference. Only difference at C1. Only difference at carbon atom number 1. At C1, you see the OH group is oriented at the right in alpha and OH group is oriented in the left in beta. Therefore, the glucose has been named as, this form of glucose has been named as alpha D plus glucose, alpha D plus glucose, alpha D plus glucose, and this form is named as beta D plus glucose. Both dextrorotatory, remember it, both dextrorotatory, this is also dextro, this is also dextro. So plus sign is given. DY is given because you know that configurational symmetry with D-glyceraldehyde, this is D-glyceraldehyde. This configurational symmetry because of this D is given, okay? And this is glucose. These are the cyclic structure of glucose. These two structures are known as cyclic fissure. Fissure cyclic structure of glucose. So fissure open chain structure of glucose, here it is. Fissure cyclic structure of glucose, this and this. If it is told that write down the structure of alpha D plus glucose, fissure cyclic structure of alpha D plus glucose, you have to write this one. Beta D plus glucose, you have to write this one. Open chain fissure, open chain structure of glucose, you have to write this one. Now we understand all these things. Clear, boys? Now come to this. In recent, there is one more representation. That representation is more appropriate. Haworth pyranose structure of glucose. Haworth pyranose structure of glucose. So before going to Haworth pyranose structure of glucose, I want to write its name here. Haworth pyranose structure. Haworth pyranose structure. Haworth pyranose structure of glucose. And then we shall discuss about fructose. Chemical properties of fructose are not there. You have to just understand the open chain structure and fissure structure and Haworth structure of fructose also. So that will be discussed in the next video. So see it here. Haworth pyranose structure, how to write? Pyran, this is a pyran, six-membered ring. This one is pyran. Pyran, see the compound, this is pyran, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, six-membered ring with oxygen. So it is not carbocyclic, there is one oxygen atom in the ring. So this compound is known as pyran. Pyran, it is very similar to pyran structure. So it is known as pyranose structure. Okay, Haworth pyranose structure because it is similar to pyran structure. So this one is pyran. The how to convert fissure structure to pyran structure. Fissure open cyclic structure to Haworth pyranose structure, because pyranose structure is a cyclic structure. Pyranose structure is a cyclic structure. So how to convert a fissure cyclic structure to pyranose structure? Look at the process. You rewrite the ring in this way, keeping oxygen here, not here. You write the ring in the oxygen atom is here in the pyran. This is the pyran ring. Then you just give vertical line at each carbon atom. asymmetric carbon. This carbon is not asymmetric. The last one is not asymmetric. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 asymmetric carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 asymmetric carbon. The last one is not asymmetric. So last one you write down at the top, CH2OH. This one, the numbering starts from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It last, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here numbering, pyran ring numbering starts from here. This is asymmetric carbon number 1. This is 2, this is 3, 4, 5. Okay, now see, look at the last asymmetric carbon atom. Last asymmetric carbon atom is joined to CH2OH and H. So this is CH2OH and this one is H. The last asymmetric carbon. This asymmetric carbon joined to CH2OH and H. Write them first. Okay, then see the vertical line 1, 2, 3, 4 at the 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. You see how to write the other asymmetric carbon atom. Look at the C1. C1 is this one. C1 OH is the right. So which are at the right in pyran structure, they will come to bottom. Which are in the right, they will come to the bottom. Okay, so this is the rule. So this is right, so right OH here, bottom. Second, right, bottom. Third, left, up, ye bottom, bottom, top. Then fourth, right again, right here, OH, rest, H. This structure is what? Pyranose structure, Haworth pyranose structure. So you have understood how to write Haworth pyranose structure looking at the cyclic structure of Fischer. The simple rule is write down the pyran ring first, give vertical line at C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. C5, there is CH2OH which is not asymmetric, and H, you write them first, CH2OH at the top and H bottom. Then from the first asymmetric carbon atom, which are at the right, write the OH group at the bottom. Right, so bottom. Right, bottom. Left, top, like this. This is pyranose structure of Haworth. This is named as a slight change in the name. What is the name? The name is alpha. This is alpha form, so it is alpha form. Alpha D plus glucopyranose. Pyranose. So in the Haworth structure, it is alpha D plus glucopyranose. This one. Similarly, you can write beta D plus glucopyranose. Beta D plus glucopyranose, there will be no difference. Only difference is at C1. C1 OH group is at the left. So you have to write OH group at the top and H is at the bottom. Rest will be same, exactly same. So when you write beta D plus glucose in Haworth pyranose structure, its name will be beta D plus glucopyranose. So alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose. What is the difference? Difference is only at here. Only at here. In the beta form, this OH will be top and H will be at the bottom. So you will practice this structure. What are the structures you have to practice? See, point-wise, Fischer open chain structure, number one, first. Then Fischer cyclic structure, alpha form and beta form. Then Haworth pyranose structure, alpha form and beta form. Alpha form and beta form in Haworth pyranose structure, it is written in this way, alpha D plus glucopyranose, beta D plus glucopyranose. Pyranose term is there. So if in the exam it comes, write down the structure of alpha D plus glucopyranose, you have to write this structure. Write one the structure of alpha cyclic structure, Fischer cyclic structure of alpha D plus glucose, you have to write this structure. Alpha D plus. If you are to write the open chain structure of Fischer open chain structure of glucose, you have to write this structure. So these structures, how many structure? One open, two cyclic Fischer structure, and two have a pyranno structure. So total 5 structures you will practice in your copy. Okay boys, next class we shall see about the different structures of fructose. Okay, fructose. Okay boys, thank you.